Hi, welcome to my channel and thank you for dropping by. My name is Yuen. I love fashion in general, but if you've seen my previous videos, I am currently obsessing over Chanel bag. But let's not dwell into that and see what's for today's video, shall we? So today's video is going to be about me going through items that I am currently selling on eBay. So for those of you wondering how I can afford luxury items, especially for the big purchases recently, that is because since the lockdown in March, I have been downsizing my bag collection and have been selling quite a number of items. And that is the reason how I can fund my recent purchases. But I currently still have about 40 items that are still listing, and I thought using this platform today probably would give them a good plug on these items. Now I won't be going through all of them because that would be way too long, and I have a number of items that I don't have them here with me. They're currently in storage at my parents' place, so I'll just run through probably about 10 items, whatever one that catch my attention, and I'll go through them with you. And for each item, I will run through three things with you. Number one, reason why I bought it in the first place. Number two, why I am selling it. And number three is the condition, the character, and basically just overall feedback or thought about that item. And with that said, let's start. And the first item, it will be a bag, and this is the Balenciaga, is that how you pronounce it? Balenciaga mini bag. I don't know the name of it to be exact. All I know is called the mini bag. Reason why I bought it in the first place, because it's just a simple, understated bag. It doesn't have the usual big logo name like how this brand does it, and it's very understated. I love the opening of the bag, which is, it's like these two flap, and it has this gorgeous burgundy lining inside, and it comes with brushed gold hardware, which is that antique kind of look. And the fact is, it's made from pebble texture leather, which I find usually is quite durable. I was really into mini bag. Well, I am still into mini bag. I just love the look. Why I am selling it, because I don't reach for this bag that often. And now that I have several mini bags in my collection, so therefore I'm not reaching for it that much, which is the right reason why I'm letting go. So a lot of my rule at the moment is, if I don't reach for a bag for a certain time period of time, I will sell it. And I have been quite blunt with my calling, so hence the reason why I'm selling that this bag. There's nothing wrong with it. And the good thing about this bag one is it, the shoulder strap is detachable and removable, and it can be used or worn as a clutch, which is really nice. I'm gonna bring it up closer for the close-up details, and you can see the stamp logo there. And just double look on the condition of it, the inside as well. So I'm just gonna remove. So it comes with the original dust bag and tag, no receipt. So here's the inside of it. There's also the engraved on the top, the top closure. And Yeah, it's a beautiful bag. Which I think it needs to go to a good home. Come back, baby, come back to me. And the next item is gonna be another bag. This is the JW Anderson Anchor Clutch bag. It's in a between gray, mushroom, and beige color. It's actually in a really pretty color. Why I bought it in the first place? Because I think I was JW Anderson had a few it bags few years back, and this was one of them, and it was on sale. I like the color, I like the look, and that was pretty much it why I bought it. Why I am selling it now, I don't wear it for a while. I haven't been wearing it for some time. I haven't reached for it, and another reason probably the chain strap that it came with. Most of this type or this model comes with two straps, so the chain strap and this short shoulder strap, which this one didn't come with. So it only came with this chain strap, and I find it's too long. I like my bag to sit, say, around here, and when it's crossbody, it should be a bit higher. So I find this strap length is too long, which is the reason why I haven't been wearing it. The only thing, or the only way that I would be wearing this probably as a clutch. I'm gonna bring it over for a close-up shot. It's still in an excellent condition. As you can see, there's no corner wear that I can see there. Let's see inside. So inside is fully leather. Beautiful soft leather inside, so it's made up of two main compartments. It actually can hold quite a number of things, so it can hold quite substantially. The only marking that I can see is that indentation where the end, this bit here, the logo, where it touches or it sits on the leather, and that's pretty much it. The rain falls on my windows and a coldness runs through my soul, and the rain falls, oh the rain falls, I don't want to be alone. I wish that I could Photoshop all our bad memories. And the next item is gonna be a jacket, a leather jacket. So this jacket is by Acne Studio. Reason why I bought it, because it was on sale and I thought it was a bargain at the time, given that it's from Acne Studio, which is a really highly sought after jacket. I loved it for a while. I've been wearing it constantly every winter. Actually mainly last winter I worn it a lot, but for this winter I haven't been reaching it for it. Must be because of this pop red color, and hence the reason why I am selling it, because I actually was contemplating whether should I sell it or should I not, because it's still such a nice beautiful leather jacket. But I have now a few leather jackets in my collection. I have two black ones and one mustard yellow. No, it's like a mustard tan color leather. Actually, that one I'm considering selling as well because I haven't been wearing that for some time. But with this one, I think it's just too bright. I'm into muted, understated color for the time being, like right now. That's my current vibe. And I find this one is a bit too bright. And if it can go to someone that who will look after it and who appreciates the color and the look, the design, yeah, I think it deserves to go to a better home. Yeah, that's the reason why. If you come back to me, I'll be all that you need. Baby, come back to me. And the next item I'm gonna show you is a Gucci watch. I've had this for a few years. I bought this, I think it was just a birthday gift for myself at the time. And I bought this because I really liked the design, the look of it. So this is the flexi glass with the brand color stripes. It's a beautiful watch as a statement piece on your wrist, but why I am selling it, because it doesn't suit me. I have such skinny wrist and it looks like it just hanging off me. So I think it suits for someone who has a fuller wrist, and it will look a lot better. But anyway, I will put it on and show it to you and let you know, see what it looks like in person, I guess. Oh, I'm putting it the wrong way. It should be, yeah, that's right. It's that way. So it's like a bangle and just snap on like that. There you go, and you just, as you can see, it's very loose on me, so it doesn't look right, even though, and that's why I can never find a bangle, or I don't wear bracelet or bangles, because I have such skinny wrist, so it needs to go to someone who suits it better, I think. There you go. Okay, so the next item is gonna be another bag, and this is from, pardon me, but I can't really pronounce this properly. I don't know really how to pronounce it. Is it M2M Moletier? It's a bit hard. It's a mouthful there. So this one was considered an it bag at the time. Beautifully designed with the top metal handle. So it can be worn as a clutch and or a shoulder bag or crossbody bag. And again, this is one of those items that I was contemplating whether should I sell or not to sell. But since I've got other items that I have been replacing this one, so I thought, yeah, it's time to sell. Why I bought it in the first place, because it was an it bag. I had this thing in the past where I used to follow a lot of trend bags, and hence I have accumulated quite a number of trendy bags in my collection. Which now I am trying to sell them or get rid of them because I don't wear them anymore. I personally think the design of this bag is quite a classic style. It's it just really nice. I just love this bag, but reason why I am selling it because I don't reach for it anymore. And that's the only thing. As you can see, it's gold, made with gold hardware, texture leather, made in Spain. Three compartments, but with one main compartment and two little ones. It can hold quite a fair number of things. The strap is removable and adjustable. With this, I love the small details on this bag, like the logo engraved or on the metal there. Yeah, it's quite an understated bag. Come back to me. Let me make up for what happened. Come back, baby, come back to me. Come back, I'll be everything. And the next three items are three pairs of shoes. Now, just in case you notice I'm in a different outfit, that's because I'm filming the last part of this video on a different day. I'm quite a busy person, so I can only squeeze in a few 1 hour or half an hour here and there to film this video. So that's why you see me in a different outfit right now. So the first pair of shoes is a pair of slides from Prada. These are, oh, by the way, I'm a size 35 or 5 US, Australian size. If you're fortunate enough to be in the same size as mine, then you are more than welcome to browse and have a look and admire these beauties and snap them up if you like. So these are, so they come in the original boxes. I'm gonna leave them down here. Which way are you in there? So they're made from satin material. They basically is really good for summer. These are in 35 and a half. It basically, yeah, will fit between a 35, or if you're in between sizes, it will be, so they will be perfect. Even if you're like a narrow foot 36, you might be able to fit in these. Reason why I bought them, because they were on sale and I thought they were pretty cute, and they from Prada, so and they were bargain at the time, so I snapped them up. But then why I am selling them is because I've only worn them a few times, and I realized, I think with my skin tone, somehow solid black color doesn't go with me. So they make, I don't know, they just make me look short. They don't really elongate my leg, so that's why I don't wear them. But they're really cute though, I have to say. So there you go. And yeah, they're quite comfortable to wear. So I'm just gonna move a bit closer for the details. Yeah, they're just cute. They're really cute. And yeah, so instead of having them sitting in the corner of my wardrobe, I'll just let them go, and hopefully they'll find the right home. The next pair is a pair of loafers from Bali. Is it Bali? So they come in the box, original box, everything. So these loafers are probably Bali's classic range. So there you go. This one. Yeah, so these are they're more like in antique white, gold hardware, size 35, the heels. collapsible that you can fold them. They still in pretty good condition. Why I bought these, I think it was just spur of the moment. I walked into the store, I was after the black color. They didn't have black color at the time, so but they showed me this color instead, and I liked them, the look of them on me at the time that I tried them out. Honestly, there's nothing wrong with them. It's just that my preference nowadays white sneakers, so I think these look a bit the same as sneaker style. And when it comes to loafers, I prefer black color with gold hardware. So that's why I decided to sell these beauties. They fit true to size and they can make an outfit look really chic. So just a closer look there for you. I've only worn them a few times, so as you can see, there aren't that many noticeable marks or scratches. Only probably darkened patches are the heel bits here. That's because I've worn them with the heels down like that, hence the darkened patches or spots over here. But other than that, another beauty is that need a new good home. Okay, the next pair of shoes item is from Chloe, the highly coveted Susanna ankle boot in the beige color. I've had these for about 5 years, I would say. I'm just gonna put the box down. I was really lusting after a pair of Susanna boots for a long time. My preference, or what I was really after, was a pair of black with gold hardware. Reason I bought these at the time, because I came across them at a good price, and I think at the time I did compromise, even though my preference at the time were really a pair of black with gold studs, but seeing that they were at good price, so I decided to buy them. I have been wearing them throughout every year for the past 5 years, but not often. Therefore, as you can see, they're still in really excellent, perfect condition because I do look after them. But now, why I am selling them, because I recently bought the black pair, the ones that I've always wanted. So I decided, why do I need to keep two pairs when I know the black one I would be reaching out for the most? So that's why I am selling these. I think they're really nice as in between seasons, say spring or autumn shoes, because they can go with dresses, skirts, or even jeans. And yeah, they, because of the color, they actually go with a lot of outfits. And the last two items in this video will be two bags. The first one is the Menso Gabriel bucket bag in the tan color. Oops. It's in a mini size. A lot of people ask me, is it mini or small, or is it mini? But the correct size for this is the mini size, which is the next size up from the mini size. Reason why I bought this, because it was a trend bag at the time. And I actually really loved the color. This is a beautiful tan, rich color, which actually has darkened through time, through usage. It's just a beautiful bag. Why I am selling this bag is because I don't wear it anymore. And this is considered to be an everyday bag where you can carry a lot of things around, bottled water or your essential stuff. So it's quite roomy. It's very light. There's no internal pocket or anything. There are marks and scratches all over, but they are just light marks and scratches. And I think that's just part of the way it just makes the bag look more attractive, like this. I'll be everything you need. Come back. Baby, come back to me. Come you're back. One in a million. So the next bag might come as a surprise for some because I recently featured this bag in one of my videos, and it is my vintage Chanel square bag. I know I've been back and forth deciding whether I should sell this bag, but now I've got quite a number of Chanels in my collection, so I know I won't be reaching this for sometimes, so I thought it's probably best for her to go to a loving home and who will appreciate her more. You've probably seen what she can hold. Even while I'm looking at it now, I'm still questioning myself whether I'm making the right decision to sell this bag. Why I love this bag is the gold-plated hardware. You won't find this sort of finish in this day in the current model, so what it means is the gold won't tarnish or fade throughout time. I mean, this bag is what, 30 years old, nearly 30 years old, yet the gold hardware is still nice and shiny. And the only, I think, why I'm not reaching for her is probably I like that puffy quilt look nowadays. So I know it's a vintage year, so that is expected of the condition of this bag. But if I'm not appreciating her, then it's probably best to send her off to a new home and then consider myself to look for, I guess, more funding to fund for the next one, I guess. I'm rambling there. Yeah, this is a reluctant sell, I would say. So that was just the roundup of items that I am currently listing on eBay. Feel free to browse more. I will list down the description and links on each item down below in description box. Any items that have been sold, I will mark them as sold in the description, so I don't want to waste your time. And if you're interested in any of the items that are featured in today's video or currently listing on my eBay store, you feel free to send me emails, queries. I'm happy to complete or do the transaction outside of eBay. What it means is I will offer a 10% discount if we're doing it outside eBay. This is because if I make transaction or complete the transaction eBay, you know the eBay fee is about 10%. So if you're okay and to do that outside eBay, then I'm happy to remove that 10% eBay fee. And that's the end of the video. I hope the content of this video was interesting and hopefully you enjoyed watching it. I also like to say thank you and really appreciate for those people that have commented in my previous videos. I've read all of them and I really appreciate your feedback. Basically, your comments actually give me more encouragement to make more videos like these. So thank you. And that's it for now, and I'll see you in my next video. Thank you. Bye.